When you build an element template, you have the option to assign a specific graphic symbol to that template. We do that with the right mouse click option, as you can see right here. Let me demonstrate what we're talking about. Here's an element template that we're familiar with. We saw earlier it's Tank Bravo. Here are the elements built on Tank Bravo. And if I were to, let me drag out another, drag this out onto the ProcessBook display. You'll notice it generates a new element. It's actually just given a generated name, Tank Bravo 1. But let's say, for example, that was Tank underscore E, the fifth tank. As you can see, it's very much like these other elements. It's just called Tank E. And you notice it picks up this graphic element. It's using this particular graphic from our graphics library, the symbol library that we ship with every Pi server. Now that wasn't by accident, of course. That happened because when you use any of the symbols within the symbol library, you can associate those symbols with an element template. And I'll show you how to do that. Let's build one from scratch. Let me delete this first. I'll go ahead and delete that element, and let's delete it from analysis framework. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to build a new template. And we'll go into the general settings for this. We have a Tank Bravo. Let's call this Tank Charlie. And it's going to have just one attribute in this case. Let's just make a reference to, we'll go with level, and we'll do that as a Pi Point data reference. And since we need to specify the naming convention, let's just use something to make it obvious what we're going to call this. We'll just call this name goes here. Now watch what happens when I make use of this. I'll go ahead and check this in. Choose File, AF Check-in. And now if I were to drag this to create, drag this template out to the workspace to create a new element of that type. So you can see it doesn't look at all like the original. Okay. It was, or like the original sets we saw, it is also generated with a new name, Tank Charlie 1. But the attribute, by the way, is using that name that we saw there. So first thing I'd have to do is change that to a, you know, to an appropriate name. Let's go with the tag CDT158. That's an existing tag. And it's retrieving values now. And I can even drag these values and put it on top of that. So it is behaving the same as these over here. It just doesn't look the same. The reason it doesn't look the same is because we have no graphic symbol associated with it. So I'm going to go ahead and build a graphic symbol. I'll go ahead and choose Symbol Library. And I'll click and drag, make this about this big. And I'll go out and look at the tanks. And I think I'll choose this tank right here. I'll go ahead and say OK. And now that tank, I would like to associate that with this particular element template. The element template, if you remember, was called Tank Charlie. So what I'd like to do is select this, right mouse click, and do assign element, or excuse me, assign symbol to template. The template I'm going to choose is Tank Charlie. If you notice, once I do that, of course, everything that already uses that is going to, that's going to propagate forward to all those elements. And of course, from the, I can delete this. I'm done with it now. Any future tanks or elements of this template that I build, if I drag out there, they're going to pick up that same symbol. It says Tank Charlie 2. Now, you see it's being added to the list of elements. So that's how we would associate a particular graphics from the symbol library to an element template. Another way you can choose which element attributes show up when you drag an element onto a screen is to go into Tools, Modeler Preferences. There's an Attributes tab that you can use to specify in this field right here the list of attributes that are going to show up separated by semicolons. So let me demonstrate. As we saw right now, my current situation is that for all elements, when I drag them onto the screen, we see only the name of the element. Or if I go into Tools, Modeler, Preferences, I can go into Attributes and set the list of attributes that will appear. I can also set the locations, as you can see here. So let's go ahead and specify that we also want to see level, and go with volume. Now, of course, there are going to be elements that don't have level and volume. This will only make those appear if those exist on the element. So it's going to look for a match. I'll go ahead and specify that. And notice next time I create an element based on that element template, or any element template, it's going to try to include those. So for example, I'll go ahead and click and drag this over. As you can see now, it has included not only the name, but also the volume and the level. And in fact, next time I load this up, each of these is going to show up showing those new attributes as well. When you drag an element from the AF browser out onto the ProcessBook display, the only thing that shows up by default is going to be the name of the element. If you'd like to add other attributes, and it's a very useful feature to do that, then you have to do that using the group option. Let me demonstrate what I'm talking about. If you notice these objects here, these tanks here, they were, when we dragged them out, the only thing that we saw in them was the name of the tank. If I would like to add other things, for example, I'd like to put the level on here, I would drag that. Also, I think I'd like to look at the total volume. And once I've got this exactly to my liking, if I would like all of the elements that are built on that element template to have that same configuration, then what we need to do is make sure you select all the objects. Let me select each of these. And I'm going to go into the Arrange menu and choose Group. Now you're going to be prompted if you want to promote this to the composite level. This essentially means that it's going to be a grouped object, a composite object. And so that's what we're going to do in this case, promote that to the composite level. Now that doesn't really, complete the procedure. The next step is using the right mouse click to choose to assign the symbol to the template again. So now that we've got the symbol that is a grouped symbol, we need to reassign that to the template. So I'll go ahead and assign that to Tank Bravo. And look at what happens with assignment. All the other objects that have already been defined and used are picking up that level and total volume.